Good day to all. Today we are going to see about the heat transfer problem. So that is a steel rod of diameter 2 cm, length 5 cm is having some kind of a load is acting. Here we have to find out with the two conditions, that is one is there is no end conversion and there is an end conversion. Okay. So the given is the diameter of the steel rod is 2 cm, that is can be converted into 0.02 meter, and the length of the rod is 5 cm, that is 0.05 meter. K is 50 watts per meter degree Celsius, T1 is 320 degree Celsius, T infinity is 20 degree Celsius, and H is 100 watts per meter square degree Celsius. Okay. So the Fe representation of the problem can be converted, the steel rod as splitted into three nodes 1, 2 and 3. So here 1 to 2 is element 1, 2 to 3 is element 2. So the LE1 is 0.0125 and 0.0125. Okay. T1 is 320 degree Celsius, T2 and T3 is there, we have to identify. Sorry, the length of the element slight change, 0.025. Okay, let me rewrite this, 0.025. Okay. So now we are going to solve the first condition, that is we are assuming that there is no end convection. So the stiffness matrix formula is A1 K1 by L1 1 minus 1 minus 1 1 plus the surface convection term HP L1 by 6 2 1 1 2. Surface convection of element 1 because the fin is exposed to atmosphere. K1 value. So the area 1 we have to find out, that is the cross section area of the rod, pi by 4 into d square. You simplify this, we will get the value of 3.142 10 power minus 4 meter square. I am writing this value A1 into K150 divided by 0.025, 1 minus 1 minus 1 1 plus heat transfer coefficient 100 into P is perimeter of the surface of the pin, that is pi into d, pi into 0.05. Here we are getting the value of 0.0628 meter. So the perimeter of the fin surface, that I am going to write here, 0.0628 into L1.025 divided by 6, 2, 1 and 1, 2. So these formulas and all already I have explained, you can check it in my playlist. By reducing this value, this term, we are getting this value plus for this term we are getting 0.052, 0.026, 0.026 and 0.052. Now by simplifying these two equations, we will get A1 equal to 604 minus 0.0024 and the remaining term like this. For K2, this element we have assumed that there is no end phase convection. So the similar values can be written for K2. So there is no end phase convection. So K1 and K2 matrix will be equal. Assemble these two equations, we will get the global stiffness matrix. Okay, you already know about assembly of global stiffness matrix, that is also explained. Please check it in playlist 1 2 3 1 2 3. For force vector for element 1 F1 and F2, the formula for force vector PHTL 1 by 2 1 1. P value we know 0.0628 into H is 100 into T infinity 20 degree, that is atmosphere temperature, into 0.025 length divided by 2 and 1 1. So the F1 and F2 can be written as 1.57 and 1.57. Similarly, for element 2, the same value will be there because there is no load vector on the end phase. Now we can assemble these two element equations. Here 3.14, 1.57, 1, 1, 2, 3. Now let us assemble these values, these force matrix, stiffness matrix, in equation kg T equal to F. Stiffness matrix I am just copying here. Let me paste it in this place. Under T1, we know that T1 is 320 degrees Celsius, T2 and T3 is equal to F value 1.57, 3.14, 1.57. Now first column second value 0.624 has to be multiplied with 320, and this value has to be added in this place so that we can neglect first row and first column. So this is the common procedure to solve heat transfer problem. 0.6024 into 320, that will give you 192.77. So the remaining value directly we can write it here. Even though it is in negative sign, that is first column second element, we can take it only a positive and multiply and plus add with nth element. Now it can be written as an equation form. By solving these two equations, we will get the value of T2 and T3, that is T2 equal to 238.4 degrees Celsius, T3 equal to 213.4 degrees Celsius. These two values we got it by assuming that there is no end conversion, that is condition 1 we have solved. Now for condition 2, we have to assume that there is an end phase convection plus surface convection of the fin for element 2 also. Element 1 will not going to change because this end phase convection will not affect the element 1. So directly the stiffness matrix we are writing here. That is the end phase convection will not affect the element 1 stiffness matrix. So we are directly writing this matrix. For element by seeing this Fe representation you can understand this is T1, T2 and T3. T3 is only subjected to the end phase convection, right? Now K2 can be written as A2 K2 by L2, 1 minus 1 minus 1 1 plus HP L2 by 6 2 1 1 2 plus the end phase convection load stiffness matrix has to be added here, that is HA0001. This is for stiffness matrix term at the end phase. Here it is surface convection, and this term is for end phase convection. Now assemble, now substitute all these values, A2 value, K2 value. K2 is common for two elements, and the remaining term, and here H value, P value, perimeter, and L2 value, divided by 6, 2, 1, 1, 2, plus H value and A value, that is cross section of the end phase, that is 3.142 × 10⁻⁴, 0001. By simplifying this first two terms, we are getting the same value as KA1, right? We can directly write it here, and plus you simplify this value, you will get zero, and only here there is a term 0.03142. So K2 is, these three terms will not change, only this term only will going to change, 0.71182. Now we have, it is 23 and 23. Now again assemble these. So directly I am writing this value. So this is for global stiffness matrix with the end phase convection. So similarly for force vector, we have 1.57, there will not be any change. And for element 2, since end phase is convected, then we have to add this term. We have to remember this formula. So that is HAT01. These formulas and all already explained in basic heat transfer. You can check it. So now F2 and F3 will become 2.19. Now assemble this into F matrix. Here only it will change. That is 3.14, and the last term will be 2.198. And again the similar procedure, the stiffness matrix has to be assembled with the T and is equal to F. Let me copy this equation and paste it here. And T1 we know that 320 degrees Celsius, T2 or T3 equal to F2 and F1, F2 and F3. circular. So this is value of 2.198. Now the similar procedure has to be followed. We so that we can neglect the first row and first column matrix. So the remaining terms directly we can write it. T2 T3, and the multiplied term has to be added here. By converting this as equation, we can write it like this: 195.91, and the second term minus 0.6024 plus 0.7182T3 equal to 2.198. By solving these two equations, we will get the value of T2 equal to 232.34 degrees Celsius, T3 equal to 199.72 degrees Celsius. This is for with the end phase conversion. Thank you very much. If you like it, please share to your friends and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much for your patience.